These Islanders team got the only goal of regulation from Brock Nelson. It came early on in the second period as Nelson, Dal Colle, Bailey Pellick all had a hand on this play.
Oh, they had a tremendous first period, 17, 18 shots, and couldn't get one by the young goaltender. And then finally, early on in the second period, and they just continued right on. They put forecheck extremely well. And it's just a great pass by Dal Colle over to Brock Nelson. But as I mentioned earlier on, Adam Pellick stays in, gets the poke check, and away he goes, and they're able to find an opportunity to score a goal. As you can see, the Islanders battling along the play, and the Islanders had several opportunities. I mean, had Jordan Eberle there, and Brock Nelson had a solid game, and continued to get better, another good shot, quick release. But the goaltender was tough tonight. He had an opportunity, and he wasn't going to let it get away on him.
Nelson's goal was his 25th of the season, one shy of his career high. He already has career highs in assists and points. He had five shots, including his goal tonight against Sam Montembeau and the Florida Panthers. Well, Butch and I said a few times throughout the broadcast the Panthers were hanging around. Barry Trotz said he couldn't get rid of them. Well, they hung around long enough, and that potent power play cashed in for the game-tying goal in the third period.
And it wasn't like, you know, get into the offensive zone and set up a play and you need to get a one-timer or a rebound. It was a brilliant breakaway pass, and Huberto looking for that opportunity, and I believe that's Yendel. And he just takes a little look, and he finds the hole, and that's just a perfect pass. And Thomas Greiss squeezes, but just couldn't quite get enough of it. It didn't beat him cold. But Huberto tried earlier on to go five hole. This time he was successful, and he's having a big season, 29 goals for him. So give him an opportunity. He's going to score.
Before this season, only two players in Panthers history had 90 points in a season. Pavel Bure, who did it twice, and Olli Jokinen, who also did it. Now the Panthers have two players with 90 points in the same season. Huberto and Barkov both there, and they're missing the playoffs.
Yeah, and that's probably a shame, and from the management standpoint, they'll want to address some areas, obviously. They feel pretty good about their team, with the exception that they didn't make the playoffs, and that's a big exception, but they did a lot of good things, and they know it, and they've just got to shore up the defensive zone. They've got to play a little sharper, a few less turnovers, be a little stronger in front of their net, and they're going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Well, after a wild overtime in which both teams had chances to win the hockey game, went to a shootout, went through three rounds of the shootout without a goal, took to the fourth round, and it took to the second shooter, Brock Nelson, to finally put one through.
Yeah, and we're sure what kind of a move he was going to make, and I talked about him. He's got the tremendous wrist shot, and would he just go in and just try to power it? But just a little fake, you see him drop his left shoulder just a little bit, and he got the goaltender, Montembeau, just hesitating a second, and that's a tough play to beat a goaltender down low, Brendan, because their initial reaction to, you know, any move is they drop to the ice and they try to take away the bottom of the net. So to be able to slide it on, you got to put a little grease on that puck and have it slide underneath the pad. But let's not forget how good Thomas Greiss was too. He gave Brock Nelson the opportunity to get the game winner.
Yeah, if you weren't convinced before, if you have the season on the line and it comes to a shootout, you want Thomas Greiss in net. His final numbers on the year, unless he sees another shootout on Saturday, he stopped 21 of 23 shooters this season in shootouts, and no one even came close to scoring tonight.
Well, tonight he was absolutely flawless. I mean, he read them like an open book. It was almost like, okay, tell me what you're going to do. Okay, that's easy. And he made it look that easy. I mean, you're right. Those guys never came close. If they used those moves, they wouldn't score in 100 tries. They just have no chance against Thomas Greiss tonight. So he certainly provided a big, big stop and gave them the opportunity.